This is a pre-built version of the application. So let's go ahead and run it. Now, currently, we only have two options for finding a schedule with zero conflicts. So either to use the genetic algorithm or hill climbing. And this is available data that we picked up from the database. So we have those three departments, and this department have those two courses offered, and this one those three, and this one those two. And for each one of the courses we have its name, the max number of students, and the instructors that are qualified to teach that course. And here we have three rooms with the seating capacity of each one. And we have four instructors in the system, and the availability for each one of them. And those are the meeting times. So a course can be scheduled for Monday, Wednesday, Friday, either from 9 to 10 or from 10 to 11, or on Tuesday, Thursday, from 9 to 10:30 or 10:30 to 12. So let's first try to find a schedule with zero conflicts using genetic algorithm. And let's run in verbose mode. So we found this schedule with zero conflicts after 29 generations. So this is this schedule. And this is a table representation of it. So we started. With this schedule with four conflicts, and this is a table representation of it, and those are the four conflicts. So we have a room booking conflict and two instructor booking conflict and one number of students conflict. So for the room booking, we have room 1 scheduled for two different courses at the same meeting time. And for instructor booking, this one, we have this instructor scheduled for two different courses at the same meeting time. And this one scheduled also for two different courses at the same meeting time. And for the number of students, we have this course . So here we have this room room one with this capacity, and we have this course that has a maximum number of students that is bigger than the room seating capacity. So we went from generation 0 to generation 1, where we found this schedule with only one conflict. And this is a table representation of that schedule. And this is the conflict, instructor booking conflict. And we kept going. For generations, and we found this schedule with zero conflicts, and we can display it from the instructor perspective. So this instructor have those two availability, meeting time 1 and meeting time 2, and he is qualified to teach those courses, and he ended up being scheduled to teach those two courses, etc. And let's do from the time perspective. So meeting time 1 have those three courses scheduled in those different rooms, and meeting time 2 have those two courses scheduled to be taught by instructor 1 and instructor 2 in room 3 and room 2. And let's display the schedule from the room perspective. So we have room 1 have two classes scheduled in meeting time 3 and meeting time 1, etc. And from the course perspective, so this course is scheduled to be taught in room 1 by instructor 2 at meeting time 3, etc. And now let's try to use hill climbing to find a schedule with zero conflicts. So we started with this schedule with six conflicts. Those are the six different conflicts, and this is a table representation of that schedule, and we kept going until we got to this schedule with one conflict. And then we tried for 20,000 iterations, and we could not get to a schedule with zero conflicts, and we consider that to be a potential maxima. So let's try again and again. And here we go. So we found this schedule with zero conflict. And same thing, we can display it from the instructor perspective and from the time perspective, room perspective, and course perspective. Now the source code is a merged version of the latest class scheduling with genetic algorithm and class scheduling with hill climbing source code. And it will be available for download and a longer and comprehensively explained version of this framework project will be available for watching by channel members at the senior developers level and above. And let's do one last thing. So let's go ahead and delete this database. And create a new database. And run using that new database. So now we have four different departments. We have this statistics and data science department with two courses offered. And we added this course for this department, etc. And now we can use a genetic algorithm to find a schedule with zero conflicts. Here we go. After 73 generations.